Hello! Today it's time for the second holiday, or mostly actually Christmas themed look that I'm going to do this year. Last week's one was more geared towards, you know, pretty much not really a basic look. It was still a party look, but something quite wearable and something quite quick and easy to do. And this week it's obviously a little bit more out there. This is actually the look that I would love to wear at Christmas, if it weren't for the fact that it takes ages to stuff this much glitter onto eyelids and have it look remotely good. This is pretty much the sort of look that I would do at Christmas if I would have a lot of time in the morning to apply makeup. But in reality, I would personally sooner do a look like the one I did last week, like I said last week. Simply because I don't want to be that person who, like, while everyone else is having a nice Christmas breakfast, is still upstairs doing her makeup for another 3 hours. So, yeah. But nevertheless, I do know that there's some people who do actually have time to do stuff like this on Christmas. And yeah, just, you know, I love doing looks like these. And I really hope you'll enjoy watching this look. If you want to do it as well, you know, like, I always hear other people say that, but I never actually said it myself. But really though, if you do recreate a look that I did, please tag me in like an Instagram post or anything. If you have Instagram, if you're comfortable, you know, sharing your makeup on Instagram. Because I'd love to see what other people make of it. Without further ado, let's get started. I'm going to start out with priming my face again with the silicone primer by The Ordinary, which in my experience to me is literally the only primer that actually seems to make a difference in how the foundation looks on me in the end. Really seems to smooth out my pores, make them look smaller. That wasn't a very charming look. Anyway. Just a very nice primer overall. Also, it's not expensive, which is also something I like. Then I'm going to start out with my eyes, and I'm going to prime first, obviously, using a concealer. This is the Maybelline 24-Hour Superstay Concealer, which, well, I really didn't buy it as an eye primer, obviously. I bought it as a concealer, but as you can tell, it oxidates, so it gets quite dark. It gets too dark for me to use it as a highlighting concealer, so instead it now lives out its life as a eyeshadow primer. It does a pretty good job at it, so that's fine. And then I'm just powdering it with my Catrice powder. Just to make sure that everything stays in place. And this will also make blending a lot easier. However, seeing as a powder puff applies quite a lot of product, I am going over it with a tiny powder brush by Real Techniques. Just to make sure that there's not too much powder on there. The eyeshadows I'm going to use are from Urban Decay. But as always, you can just use anything you want, anything you like. I don't know what I was thinking there just now. But for some reason I managed to point at the pale green eyeshadow and then use the lime green one. I was meaning to use the lime green one, so I have no idea why I pointed at the other one. And I cut out the frame, but then I managed to point at the lime green one and then proceed to use the pale green shades to do my crease. Logic. But yeah, as you can see, you know, the order it should be done in is lime green and then pale green. And then I'm moving over to even darker green to define the first wing, really. I'm doing that using an angled brush by Sigma. And don't worry yet about making the line very crisp, because this is only the first step. And there's going to be a lot more steps to really define the double wing. I'm also starting to define the crease with this. And then I actually switched to a different brush. A brush by BH Cosmetics, quite a dense blending brush, to apply some more, because it just went quicker than with the angled brush. Then below my eye, I use a pencil brush by Sigma to apply the red eyeshadow. And do be careful with red eyeshadows. I'm not actually sure if this one is supposed to be used near the eye, but some actually may stain the skin, so again, be careful with it. I never had issues with this one though, personally. Then I continued on defining the double wing with a sort of, as you can see, a dark shade of grey. Sort of a warm grey. With a very tiny brush by Urban Decay. And yeah, what I just do, well, what I do right now, by the way, is blending it out with a pencil brush by Bougie Brush. But anyway, the thing is, I really didn't know how dark I wanted to make this. So I decided to just start out with dark grey, because you can always make it darker, whereas it's quite difficult, of course, to make things paler again. So yeah, I just started out with this color and then just kept blending both on the top and on the bottom. But I did try to keep the lime green separated from the crease. So I did blend out, as you can see here, with a tiny brush by Boozy Brush to make sure it really goes into the crease. But I try to only keep it on the outer V on the eyelid and not do it all the way over the green. Then just used a big fluffy blender by Sigma to blend out the top part. And then I did actually decide to make it even darker. For that I used the darkest shade in the Naked 3 palette, which actually has red glitters in it, so that makes it very suitable for this look. And well, as you can tell, I pretty much just literally did the exact same thing as I did with the grey. Only, of course, I did keep this color a little bit, you know, closer to the actual wings. Just to make sure that it blends really nicely. And there's some other things that it will help with. Like, not only is it safer to start with a paler shade, because you can always make it darker. But starting with a paler shade first will also make sure that the black is easier to blend. So, yeah, admittedly, I did, of course, cut out a lot of the blending process, because otherwise this video would be, like, an hour long. But really, it didn't really take all that much time to blend, and that is one thing with using quite expensive eyeshadows. The ones by Urban Decay are very easy to blend, so that does make them quite, you know, nice to work with. Then to make the, you know, the skin between the wings more pale, I decided to use concealer. This one is my Catrice concealer in the lighter shade, obviously, and I just applied that with a eyeliner brush by Sigma. And then I set it with my I Heart Makeup Unicorn's Heart Highlighter. Long name. But yeah, this makes everything pale and sort of shimmery. And then it's time for glitter, the fun part. Well, actually the other parts were a lot of fun to do as well, but I just really love glitter. So I'm just using the Glitter Primer by NYX. Everywhere where I also applied the Lime Green eyeshadow. And then I'm also applying the glitter. I'm using gold in the inner corner and then green on the rest of the eyelid. Just with a fluffy brush by, I think it was EcoTools. Yeah, it was EcoTools. And also, to be on the safe side, do try to use eye safe glitter. Because, you know, your eyes are pretty important. Probably. So, yeah. And then I also decided to add some rhinestones. The rhinestones are just from a Buddhist store. I don't think eye safe rhinestones exist. But you're not supposed to put them inside your eyeballs anyway. I'm using liquid latex to glue them on because I know they will stick, and they'll stick as for as long as I want them to. However, if you don't have liquid latex, you can also use eyelash glue. Just make sure you use really strong glue because, you know, you don't want the rhinestone to randomly fall off during the day. If you really are going to wear something like this at Christmas, I would really love to, but I just really can't find the time for it, unfortunately. But yeah, I wanted to have the pale shade in the, you know, skin between the wings to also come up somewhere else, so I did my waterline in white. And then decided to use a liquid liner to define the wings a little bit more. I didn't do a full eyeliner because doing a full eyeliner over top of glitter is very, very difficult. Because of course glitter has texture and it's just basically impossible to make it look, you know, nice and straight. I was actually on the fence about whether or not to use mascara. I was going to use mascara anyway, but whether or not to use falsies. But I just didn't really want to risk the falsies covering anything of the whole double wing thing or of the glitter. So I just decided to go for a lot of mascara instead. This is the Colossal Cat Eye Mascara by Maybelline. Also, sorry if you can hear noise in the background. Pardon, I have some new neighbors and obviously they're working on stuff and yeah, that's the noise you can probably hear. But yeah, anyway, I also decided to make it a little bit of a cut crease by adding very dark grey eyeshadow in the crease, obviously. This one is by Kiko. And then I'm just blending it out with a pencil brush again. And I did try to keep this color very, very low because I didn't want to cover all the green in the crease. And then finally the eyes are done and it's time for the face. I'm going to start out with the coverage foundation by The Ordinary. Yes, I pretty much killed the pump already. But anyway, I actually, at first I didn't really like this foundation all that much. Especially not from up close, but then I applied it with a beauty blender and it looks absolutely amazing. So yeah, I do actually like it now and I'm also very happy that I finally, the last person on earth probably, what a beauty blender, but anyway, I then moved on to contouring. I used a cream contour by Kiko. I think there's two shades. I bought the darkest one and yeah, also blended it out with a beauty blender. And then repeated the process but then with highlighter in my highlighting areas, and I used my Catrice concealer for that. And no matter how I apply it, that concealer, like whether it is with a brush or with a beauty blender, I love that concealer. Like, it's seriously my favorite at the moment. Which is quite surprising because it is so cheap and it's so amazing and I love it. But yeah, then I applied my Catrice powder on top of it with a powder puff underneath my eyes and everywhere where I get oily quickly. Which is, in my case, pretty much my entire face. And then went over everything with a powder brush by Sigma just to make sure that no spots are too powdery and that everything does have some powder on it. I really don't like it if my face is sticky anywhere from the makeup. Then for blush, I always have issues opening packages like this. But yeah, I used one by Kiko and I applied it with a stippling brush by Sigma just to make sure that I didn't apply too much. It is a very lovely shade, very easy to build. But as you can probably tell, I'm quite a ghost in winter. So I didn't want to end up, you know, having bright red cheeks. Then for highlighter, I used the Unicorn's Heart Highlighter again. This time with a very tiny brush. Sort of a powder brush. I really don't know how this one is called officially, but it's by Real Techniques. And obviously just applied it in all my highlighting areas. And also, about this highlighter, I really, really love how versatile it is. This time I just used all the colors blended together, but, you know, sometimes I just use the blue one or just the yellow one. It's really, really lovely. I don't really use it on no makeup days or anything, but when I use a lot of makeup, I really, really do like how intense it is. And I also applied a little bit of it with a tinier brush underneath my eyebrows. And then it's finally time to make my face look more complete by adding actual visible eyebrows to it. I'm starting out with the NYX Tamer Frame Brow Pomade with my eyeliner. Or not eyeliner, nail art brush, which I use for eyeliner and brows. Yep. Just filled them in basically and then combed them in place with the L'Oreal Brow Plumber. Just to make sure that all the hairs stay where they're supposed to be all day long. And yeah, the difference is quite significant. And then I decided to go to the last step finally and break my own rule and use a product that isn't actually available anymore. This one is by Essence. It's really, really old, but it's just a basic red shade, dark red with sort of a satin finish. And I really think it fits very well with the eye look. And yeah, then that's the final result. I really, really, really love doing looks like these. I love wearing looks like these. I just wish I'd have time to do a look like this on actual Christmas Day. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, thank you very much for watching and hope to see you next time. Bye!